But with the limited amount of time we've got left, what can we say to help try to alleviate some of the nonsensical fear that is about to crash our economy and evaporate all the rights of societies based on nonsense? Can you think of anything that's important to mention here?
Well, one thing I think, in order to maintain some rationality, I try to use this test, and I've seen some people like post things on social media like this, and it really does work. Just ask yourself, do I know anyone who is ill right now? And do I know anyone who has died? And, if something is really so dangerous, it's going to affect your world. If it's not part of your world yet, then it's hard to say how real something is.
Well, what's funny is Jason and I are aware of an individual who's probably got over 500,000, maybe 250,000 followers. And he put out the statement, "Oh, someone died. Can you tell me their name? I know 5 people that died of this, that, or the other thing. Can you give me a single name of a person who's died from this?" But let's just make one final point. It has been calculated that every day when all us human beings walk out our front door, there is roughly a 1% chance that we might die that day. Even if we took all the false news reporting as true and calculated out the level of death attributed to those false news reports, it would be 0.03 or something like that. In other words, a very small fraction of the 1% risk we take every day. And there's no way to substantiate or prove as real what this is based on in the first place. So how is it that if we take a larger risk than what's supposedly going on in the world just by walking out our door, universities, schools, business, well, basically everything that matters is going to be closed. Disneyland is closed, of course. Of course, poor Tom Hanks is down there in Australia dying of coronavirus, that poor man. And Disney World just closed. But my point here is everybody knows this is going to crash the economy to some level. And it is all based on a thing that is completely and utterly indefensible. And the thing that is allowing it to occur is human fear. One of these things is provably not true. One of these things is provably true. The thing that is provably true is the level of childlike fear that has permeated the world mind. Is there anything you'd like to add before we wrap up here, Dr. Kaufman?
Well, I totally agree. And I think I would definitely recommend for people to think about that fear and is there really cause for it? And, I would encourage people to tune out from all the sensational fear porn that seems to be pervasive. Because, even I am susceptible to that. I looked at a page on the web like this and, just reading a couple of sentences, my heart started palpitating. And, so I realized that I turned it off and then I looked for confirmatory information. And what I found was that there was no cause for concern.
So what we're basically looking at here in closing is the biggest coup d'etat that has ever been attempted from my point of view. What you're seeing is the fact that, I don't know if you want to call it war, maybe coup d'etat is a better word, has traded in bombs and bullets for information in the digital age. So what's going on here? Rights are going to evaporate, economies are going to crash, and there is not a shred of adult calculation that can be made to show that there was a reason to have done it. And what we can show is endless fear porn, endless media, endless movies, all ratcheting up fear. But Dr. Kaufman, I want to thank you so much for coming back on and offering a little sanity to a world. And before I let you say bye and tell people where they can find you. And by the way, people have been trying to find you.
yes, I know.
I will. Yeah, I bet you do. My server crashed 3 times. I will offer this. Everybody listening, you're going to be fine today. The vast majority of us going to be fine tomorrow. The vast, vast majority of us going to be fine the day after that. Dr. Kaufman, what would you like to offer up in terms of contact information in closing?
Yes, and thank you so much for having me on. It's really an honor for me to be here. People can reach me through my email, and I'm going to spell it out this time. It's drandykaufman@protonmail.com. That's drandy KAUF as in Frank, MAN at protonmail.com. And please check out my YouTube channel, which is just in my name, Andrew Kaufman. I hope everybody can get in touch with me who wants to.
All right, man. I'm digging the proton mail there. Good for you, man.
Anyhow, I
got to thank you one more time in this kind of hyper freaked out world that's going on around us right now. It's much ado about nothing, but for you to make time back to back for us. And the first time, you know, it takes three, sometimes close to 4 hours to do a full episode. So for you to do this, and by the way, I sent an email last night and then another this morning saying, Doctor, can you do this? So it was very short notice. Anyhow, I know certainly Jason has a bunch of things he's got to deal with. Jason, anything you want to get in, or are you ready to wrap?
No, I'm good, man. Let's wrap her up.
All right, there it is. I don't know what the episode number is, but when we post it, there will be a number attributed. I want to wish all the best to everybody. And there is no absolute zero reason for fear. What's going to happen to the economy, that's going to suck. But all the rest of it, no reason to fear. Cheers.